Get ready to match the stars. Larry Hovis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patti Deutsch, Richard Dawson, and Madlyn Rhue as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
They're a lively bunch, aren't they?
Certainly are.
Are you a lively bunch?
Yes.
Certainly are.
Good night. According to what you had in mind.
I guess they're ready for it, aren't we? All right, let's get right to it, folks. And say hello to Kathy Edwards and Dorothy Zinni here. How are you, ladies?
Fine.
Dorothy's the current champ. She's won one game, has $600 under her belt. She's being challenged by Kathy Edwards, who's had two questions. One question. Oh, that's right. We're going to go to the other half of whatever. What are we going to do here? We're going to go to round two is what we're going to do. All right, we'll do it. But first, we got to do a little business with you. Then you come right back. Hello there. Here we go. Let me push this button and reveal. Oh, yes, we got to start with round two. That's what we're going to do. All right, Kathy, you've got to match five people to stay in the running here. And you will make a selection. We ask you to do it because some contestants find some of these questions more difficult than others. What would you like to do here?
I'd like to take B this time, please.
You want to take B? All right. Everybody will play. Folks, Janet has a weird house. The blank is in the kitchen.
Who has a weird house, darling?
Janet.
Oh, I thought you said Shannon.
No, Janet has a weird house. The blank is in the kitchen. Okay. Now we're all set over there. So we'll call on Kathy. Janet has a weird house. The blank is in the kitchen.
The bathroom is in the kitchen.
She says the bathroom is in the kitchen. This is a grand group. They're applauding John's now. All right. What do you say, Larry? Her answer is bathroom.
Oh, I'll have a shower and eggs.
Have a shower and eggs. Did
I said that. Toilet.
All right, there's a match. Brett?
Not tasteful, but accurate. Actually, you may think this strange, but I lived in a terribly chic neighborhood in New York, and the bathtub was in the kitchen, and I said the John was in the kitchen.
There's another one. Okay. Charles?
I didn't think it was so unusual. I said her bed was in the kitchen.
That's unusual. Okay. Now, Kathy, you've got two. That means you must match the remaining three to achieve a tie. Let's see if it happens.
Well,
Patti.
Being a sophisticate, I said the potty is in the
potty. Okay, there's a... You need the other two. Richard, are you going to help this lady out?
By the way, the kiddies concert is canceled.
Of course I'll help her out. The bathroom.
Madeline, it's up to you. She must match you to stay in the game.
Well, the bathtub was in the kitchen.
Oh, that's not bathroom. So, Dorothy Zinni is the winner. Congratulations.
I win.
Yeah. Over here. Come any way you want.
This one?
What's that?
I didn't even work for this one.
Oh, yes, you did.
One. I really worked.
Yes, all right. You're doing very well here. Kathy, that was very, very close there. We thank you very much for being with us on Match Game 74. It was a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you backstage. Kathy Edwards, baby.
Thank you.
You're surprised to be here, are you?
I really am. I mean, last time it was hard work.
Yeah, but this time was easy.
Oh, yeah. It gets easier.
Yes, it does. That's what they say. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Now what do you want to do?
I never said
I'm ready.
That.
Oh, you're ready. Okay. She's ready for the big money super match where she can win over $5,000. Dorothy, we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Power blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Second one is $250 if you match that one, or the third, $100. All right, which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Brett.
Powerhouse.
Powerhouse is hers.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Charles.
power shortage.
That's good, too.
Uh-huh, and Madlyn.
Madlyn?
Power failure.
Power failure.
Oh, they're all so good.
Yep, you've got powerhouse, power shortage, and power failure. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Powerhouse.
Powerhouse is the one she's looking for. She thinks that's up there under the $500 response. And we'll find out right now if it's up there at all, shall we?
Uh-huh.
First, may we see the $100 response?
Powerhouse it is, right off the bat.
Let me explain. The sign writer is a Scot. And that's a power hoose. That's absolutely right. Just trying to get him off the hook.
Power hoose there. Well, anyway, you got the $100. Now let's find out what's under the, if we may, under the $250 response. Power failure. That was up there, the one Madlyn gave you. All right. Here. What do you think is under the $500?
Shortage. I'm dumb. Yeah.
You're dumb. It's shortage. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
She's saying I'm dumb, too.
Hey, we say the $500 response. Power more. Oh, yeah. Shortage wasn't even up there. Power more there.
I almost would have picked that.
Okay, you've got the $100. That means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount now, or $1,000. To collect the $1,000, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be exact. Which one will it be?
Charles.
Charles, you ready?
Oh, no.
Yes.
All right.
Charles is ready. To write, you face me, if you would, please.
Good luck, Dorothy.
And here it is. Please write your answer to this, Charles. Oh. Have a blank. Have a blank.
Have a?
Have. It's two words I'm giving you. Have, H-A-V-E, A, a, blank. Charles is mumbling to himself. Did you think of one, Charles? Okay, he's put it in the slot. Now, Dorothy, it's up to you to fill in the blank. Have a...
ball. Have a ball. Uh-huh. I'm having a ball.
Have a ball is her answer, and I guess it's a logical response.
Have a heart. I'm sorry.
Have a heart.
I didn't know that was it. I thought this was the big one for me.
Well, you...
Dorothy,
wait,
belted.
I had to up there give him a belt. Back.
We're all on the Dorothy Zinni show. It's not going off the air yet.
All right.
Have
that
a
was
nice
very
day.
Good. It was
that
good
was
answer.
Right,
yours.
Dorothy.
No, yours was good. No, that was a good answer. Both answers were good. That's the thing about this game. Listen, you're going to play another game and meet another challenger, but first we got to do a little business here, and then you stick around.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Come right back. A lot of good stuff happens when you go away for commercials. You. All right. No, I'm only kidding there. Are you ready, ladies? Oh, let's meet a new player. Here is Candy Carter. Hi, Candy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Good.
A little nervous.
You want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay. I live in Huntington Beach, California. I'm a graduate of Cal Poly Pomona. I work as a health insurance claims examiner, and I'm single.
Okay. All right.
I'll take one from column four.
Okay. Good luck to both ladies. I'll push the button and reveal the board with the two questions on it and ask our challenger to make a decision.
I'll take B.
She says she wants B, and this is it. This is a new game.
Oh, okay.
Are you ready?
Oh, I'm so glad you told me.
Oh, splendid. When the first astronauts landed on Mars, they were greeted by a Martian selling blank. When the first astronauts landed on Mars, they were greeted by a Martian selling...
What I want to know, Charles, is why? Why us? We could be working in the book department at Macy's.
Greeted by a Martian selling... Use anything you want. Anything you want, Charles. Anything you think might match.
I could say...
Sure. Say anything. Okay, now they're all set. We'll call on Candy. When the first astronauts landed on Mars, they were greeted by a Martian selling...
real estate.
Real estate is a good answer. It's the first thing that I thought of. That's not bad at all. Larry, what came to your mind?
Well, aluminum siding came to my mind.
Aluminum siding. Well, you didn't say that, did you?
I didn't say that.
That's a nice thought,
no,
Larry.
I said coffee.
Hot coffee. It was cold on Mars.
I suppose.
All right, Brett.
That's not as tasteless as toilet. I'll go along with that. I said peanut butter.
Peanut butter.
I don't know why I said peanut butter.
Dumb.
Beauty's always been my stalking trait.
That's right. But we love you, Brett. All right, Charles.
There's only one thing a man from Mars can sell.
Mars bars.
Right. Oh, how about that answer? Charles. And they're cheaper there. They're much cheaper there.
Yeah, they haven't had the inflation there.
Let's move on.
Okay. Patti?
I said maps to the stars' homes.
Maps to the stars' homes. That's very good, Patti. Very good.
Very good.
Richard?
Not right. But
I happen to know that the Martians were selling candy, but they were Earth bars.
Earth bars.
Just a little...
little twist there.
If you don't like sophisticated stuff, folks, don't get hostile. I've got two kids to support, and I am a veteran. Next to Huckleberry Dillinger here.
Madlyn? I said that he wanted to sell them some land.
Land and real estate is a match. So you scored one there. Okay, now we're going to do the other one. All right, you ready?
Ready.
Okay, Dorothy says she's ready. Folks?
Yes, but are we?
The acrobat blanked his wife on the trampoline.
I'm a mother, you know.
Yes. And he's a veteran. The acrobat blanked his wife on the trampoline. Dorothy's thinking about that one. We ready down here? Okay, Brett, put it in the slot there.
I don't. I'm afraid somebody will misinterpret.
So you're going to change?
All right. What is that word for.
No clues because we still haven't called on Dorothy, so.
All right. Oh, good gravy. If you think my life is easy, you're crazy.
Should we all go out for a spot of tea or something?
Okay. I'm so sorry. Right. My first answer was the best one.
The acrobat blanked his wife on the trampoline.
Flipped his wife on the trampoline.
Flipped his wife on the trampoline.
Uh-huh.
Wait till you hear what they wrote. All right. Larry, the acrobat blanked his wife on the trampoline. Flipped is her answer. What do you say?
Well, I wrote dropped.
He dropped his wife on the trampoline.
Yeah.
Back to Hogan's Heroes for you there, Larry. Okay, Brett.
Now, you see, that's the word I was trying to think of, except that what I used was the word jumped, and I knew that there might be certain people who would miss it.
Yeah, right.
So I said, but that's what I meant, was flipped. I meant flipped.
But you wrote kiss. Okay.
Yes.
All right. I'm glad you explained that whole thing.
We're a little late, folks. Bounced.
Bounced and flipped. How about that? Is that a match? No. All right. And what do you say?
Kissed
his wife on the trampoline.
Well, she's
and that's
nearly
why
married.
He broke money. No. What do you say there, Richard?
He did drop her, and she came up tails.
And you, Madlyn?
Well, he was mad at her, so he hit her.
He hit his wife on the trampoline. Okay, so at this moment, at the end of round one, the score is 1-0 in favor of our challenger, and we're going to go to round two, but first we've got to go to this message for you. Here we go. I'll push the button. And reveal round two and ask Candy Carter, who's ahead at this moment 1-0, to make a selection.
I'll try B again.
She wants B again. Last time you matched Madlyn, so Madlyn, you will not participate.
Oh.
All right?
I wondered why that thing was going...
Don't write, it says.
Yeah, I thought
she
I had
matched
done
you
something wrong.
Last round. Eddie said to the booking agent, I have a very unusual act. I play Yankee Doodle Dandy by banging my blank against a wall. Aren't you sorry you're not playing, Madlyn?
I wish I were.
I play Yankee Doodle Dandy by banging my blank against a wall.
He's a very good printer, Larry.
Yes, he is. Okay, everybody ready? So we'll call on Candy Carter. Eddie said to the booking agent, I have a very unusual act. I play Yankee Doodle Dandy by banging my blank against a wall. What do you say to that, Candy?
It's got to be head.
Head. Yeah, that's... Not a bad answer at all. Similar to that old vaudeville, or I guess I've seen that on television, where a guy, play song by, you know
yeah,
that?
I think you'll find that was Oral Roberts.
That's something. Yeah, that's what I mean. What do you say, Larry?
You sure can ad-lib. I said head.
Head. You want candy, Brett?
I love you when you go to pieces like that. I get all overstimulated.
I said head.
Okay, two for you, Candy. Charles?
Well, I had that act. I used to bang my shirt against the wall and sing Yankee Doodle Dandy.
And
but
I've
seen said
it.
Head.
Head. Okay. So you tap to the
red
upper tier. Let's see what you do down here.
A reprise of head.
A head. Another head there. You're doing very well with this. Let's see what you do with Richard Dawson.
You know the old saying, five heads are better than one.
That's it. So you got them all. So that means, at this moment, it's 6-0, you've got to match everybody to stay in the game.
Okay.
Here we go. She's ready.
Okay, whatever it is. She'll
she's got to come out of herself.
Listen carefully. Yeah, she's got to come out of herself. The one ad read, room for rent, $100 per month, or free if you'll share it with my blank. This is a want ad. It read, room for rent, $100 per month, or free if you'll share it with my blank. Are these too hard for you, Patti?
No, I'm zipping right along.
All right. Okay, we're all set. Madlyn?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay. Remember, you've got to match everybody. Think carefully before you give us a response. The want ad read, room for rent, $100 per month, or free if you'll share it with my...
dog.
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 All right, we need six dogs for Dorothy to stay in the
game. You've got six dogs, huh?
Speak for yourself, Miss Madlyn. Larry, would you... let's see if she matches you. May we see your card, please? Show and tell time, Larry.
Dog.
Oh! Dog! There's one for you. Brett?
I'm so sick and tired of being the villain of the piece.
Oh, Brett.
I said mother.
Who was a dog?
So Candy Carter is a winner. Congratulations. All right, you've got $100. Okay. We'll get back to Candy in a moment or so, but right now we've got to say goodbye to Dorothy. We're sorry to see you go, Dorothy.
Oh, I really had fun.
Yeah,
I'm
well,
not sorry.
You're terrific.
Thank you.
Well,
you're
Dorothy
in heaven.
You are
thank
heaven,
you, Dorothy
Dorothy.
Zinni, for being on Match Game 74.
Thank you all.
Bye-bye. Okay. You know what this means, this big thing swirling around that way? What's it mean?
It means I can win some more money.
All right, you can win over $5,000 here if all goes well for you. Let's get right to it. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Purple blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you can match it. Second, $250, third, $100, and you're allowed to get a little help. Name three.
Madlyn.
Purple People Eater.
Purple People Eater is what Madlyn says, okay?
Richard.
Purple Heart.
Purple Heart.
You get that through eating an indelible pencil.
That's it.
Charles.
I wish I had one now, a Purple Passion.
Purple Passion?
So do I, huh?
It's a drink okay. with grape juice.
So you've got Purple People Eater, Purple Heart, and Purple Passion. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own and give it to us, but right now we have to call for an answer.
I'm going to say Purple People Eater.
Well, I say Purple People Eater. That's yours, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's find out if it is indeed up there, and if so, where it is. We're looking for Purple People Eater. May we see the $100 response? Purple Passion, the thing that Charles said.
And it's lovely in a small glass.
Promises,
all right,
promises.
We're looking for Purple People Eater. May we see the $250 response? Purple Heart is Richard's answer. That's there. Well, third and last chance, Candy, to look for a Purple People Eater. Here is the $500 response. Purple People Eater is up there. Very good. So, you got a big assist there from Madlyn Rhue. And you've got the $500. That means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000. Remember, you've got to match one celebrity now, head-to-head. Has to be an exact match, and you have to choose one now.
I'm going to stick with Madlyn.
All right, Madlyn, you get ready to write, okay. And you will face me, if you would, please. This is the $5,000 question. Treasure blank. Treasure blank. Okay, Madeline's finished her answer. And now, Candy, you give us yours. Treasure
hunt.
Treasure hunt. So some of you were saying, what were you saying? What do you think it is? Treasure island, treasure chest is what the audience thinks. All right, Madeline, for $5,000, may we see your answer, please? Treasure hunt is hers.
I said treasure hunt.
Hunt! Well, I can hardly wait until tomorrow because you're just terrific, all of you.
Well, you're going to have to wait.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Thank you.
Today's consolation prizes are the Weekender by American Tourister, designed to go everywhere by land, sea, or air. Fiberglass reinforced suction, strong lightweight luggage by American Tourister. And heavy-duty Glamourine rug shampoo, the rug cleaner that's the efficient, easy way to clean or brighter rugs from Glamourine. And a supply of Wizard air fresheners, light, fresh fragrances and aerosol, solid, and wick air fresheners Wizard, a natural way to freshen your home. And a supply of Swiss Miss Cocoa, delicious toffee, mocha, cinnamon, malt, and chocolate flavored instant mixes, just add hot water. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations. Get ready to match the stars. Larry Hovis, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patti Deutsch, Richard Dawson, and Madlyn Rhue as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
They're a lively bunch, aren't they?
Certainly are.
Are you a lively bunch?
Yes.
Certainly are.
Good night. Tell according to what you had in mind.
I guess they're ready for it, aren't we? All right, let's get right to it, folks. And say hello to Kathy Edwards and Dorothy Zinni here. How are you, ladies?
Fine.
Dorothy's the current champ. She's won one game, has $600 under her belt. She's being challenged by Kathy Edwards, who's had two questions. One question. Oh, that's right. We're going to go to the other half of whatever. What are we going to do here? We're going to go to round two is what we're going to do. All right, we'll do it. But first, we've got to do a little business with you. Then you come right back. Hello there. Here we go. Let me push this button and reveal. Oh, yes, we've got to start with round two. That's what we're going to do. All right, Kathy, you've got to match five people to stay in the running here. And you will make a selection. We ask you to do it because some contestants find some of these questions more difficult than others. What would you like to do here?
I'd like to take B this time, please.
You want to take B? All right. Everybody will play. Folks, Janet has a weird house. The blank is in the kitchen.
Who has a weird house, darling?
Janet.
Oh, I thought you said Shannon.
No, Janet has a weird house. The blank is in the kitchen. Okay. Now we're all set over there. So we'll call on Kathy. Janet has a weird house. The blank is in the kitchen.
The bathroom is in the kitchen.
She says the bathroom is in the kitchen. This is a grand group. They're applauding John's now. All right. What do you say, Larry? Her answer is bathroom.
I'll have a shower and eggs.
Have a shower and eggs.
I said toilet.
All right, there's a match. Brett?
Not tasteful, but accurate.
Yeah. I am.
Actually, you may think this strange, but I lived in a terribly chic neighborhood in New York, and the bathtub was in the kitchen, and I said the John was in the kitchen.
There's another one. Okay. Charles.
I didn't think it was so unusual. I said her bed was in the kitchen.
That's unusual. Okay. Now, Kathy, you've got two. That means you must match the remaining three to achieve a tie. Let's see if it happens.
Well,
Patti.
Being a sophisticate, I said the potty is in the
potty. Okay, there's a... You need the other two. Richard, are you going to help this lady out?
By the way, the kiddies concert is canceled.
Of course I'll help her out. The bathroom.
Okay. Madlyn, it's up to you. She must match you to stay in the game.
Well, the bathtub was in the
Oh, that's not bathroom. So, Dorothy Zinni is the winner. Congratulations.
I win.
Yeah. Oh. Over here. Come any way you want.
This one?
What's that?
I didn't even work for this one.
Oh, yes, you did.
One. I really worked.
Yes, all right. You're doing very well here. Kathy, that was very, very close there. We commercials, you... All right. No, I'm only kidding there. Are you ready, ladies? Oh, let's meet a new player. Here is Candy Carter. Hi, Candy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Good.
A little nervous.
You want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay. I live in Huntington Beach, California. I'm a graduate of Cal Poly Pomona. I work as a health insurance claims examiner, and I'm single.
Okay. All right.
I'll take one from column four.
Okay. Good luck to both ladies. I'll push the button and reveal the board with the two questions on it and ask our challenger to make a decision.
I'll take B.
She says she wants B, and this is it. This is a new game.
Oh, okay.
Are you ready?
Oh, I'm so glad you told me.
Splendid. When the first astronauts landed on Mars, they were greeted by a Martian selling blank.
What I want to know, Charles, is why? Why us? We could be working in the book department at Macy's.
Greeted by a Martian selling... Use anything you want. Anything you want, Charles. Anything you think might match.
I could say...
Sure. Say anything. Okay, now they're all set. We'll call on Candy. When the first astronauts landed on Mars, they were greeted by a Martian selling...
Real estate.
Real estate is a good answer. It's the first thing that I thought of. That's not bad at all. Larry, what came to your mind?
Well, aluminum siding came to my mind.
Aluminum siding. Yeah. Well, you didn't say that, did you?
I didn't say that.
That's a nice... Thought,
no, I said coffee.
Hot coffee. It was cold on Mars.
I suppose.
All right, Brett.
That's not as tasteless as toilet. I'll go.
Power failure. That was up there, the one Madlyn gave you. All right, here. What do you think is under the $500?
Shortage. I'm dumb. Yeah.
You're dumb. It's shortage. That's what you're saying?
Yes.
She's saying I'm dumb too.
Hey, we saved the $500 response. Power more. Oh, yeah. Shortage wasn't even up there. Power more then.
I almost would have picked that.
Okay, you've got the $100. That means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount now, or $1,000. Okay. To collect the $1,000, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be exact. Which one will it be?
Charles.
Charles, you ready?
Oh, no.
Yes. All right.
Charles is ready. To write, you face me, if you would, please.
Good luck, Dorothy.
And here it is. Please write your answer to this, Charles. Oh. Have a blank. Have a blank.
Have a...
Have, it's two words I'm giving you. Have, H-A-V-E, A, a, blank. Charles is mumbling to himself. Did you think of one, Charles? Okay, he's put it in the slot. Now, Dorothy, it's up to you to fill in the blank. Have a...
Ball. Have a ball.
Have a ball is her answer, and I guess it's a logical response.
Have a heart. I'm sorry.
Have a heart.
I thought this was the big one for me.
Well, you...
I thought
Wait.
I had to up there and give him a belt. Back.
We're all on the Dorothy Zinni show. It's not going off the air yet.
All right.
Have a nice day. That was very good.
It was a good answer.
Right,
no years was good. No, that was a good answer. Both answers were good. That's the thing about this game. Listen, you're going to play another game and meet another challenger, but first we got to do a little business here, and then you stick around.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Come right back. A lot of good stuff happens when you go away for command.
Thank you very much
for being with us on Match Game 74. It was a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you backstage. Kathy Edwards,
thank you.
You're surprised to be here, are you?
I really am. I mean, last time it was hard work.
Yeah, but this time was easy.
Oh, yeah. It gets easier.
Yes,
definitely.
It does. That's what they say. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Now what do you want to do?
I'm ready.
Oh, you're ready. Okay. She's ready for the big money super match where she can win over $5,000. Dorothy, we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Power blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Second one is $250 if you match that one, or the third, $100. All right, which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Brett.
Powerhouse
is hers.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Charles.
Power shortage.
That's good, too.
And Madlyn.
Madlyn?
Power failure.
Oh, they're all so good.
Yep, you've got powerhouse, power shortage, and power failure. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Powerhouse
is the one she's looking for. She thinks that's up there under the $500 response. And we'll find out right now if it's up there at all, shall we?
Uh-huh.
First, may we see the $100 response?
Powerhouse it is, right off the bat.
Let me explain. The sign writer is a Scot. And that's a power hoose. That's absolutely right. Just trying to get him off the hook.
Power hoose there. Well, anyway, you got the $100. Now let's find out what's under the, if we may, under the $250 response.